Good morning. Billy, please read the problem, and Bobby, please translate.
Flippin' physics.
A 5.0 kilogram mass experiences a net force causing the object to go from an initial velocity of 4.0i minus 3.0j meters per second to a final velocity of 2.0i plus 6.0j meters per second. What is the net work acting on the mass during this event?
Mass equals 5.0 kilograms. Velocity initially equals 4.0i minus 3.0j meters per second. Velocity final equals 2.0i plus 6.0j meters per second. And net work equals question mark.
Thank you both. Bo, please begin solving the problem.
Well, we have two equations for work. Work equals the dot product of the force doing the work and the displacement of the object. We use that equation when the force is constant. The other equation is work equals the integral from initial to final position of the force in the x direction with respect to x. We use that equation generally when the force is not constant. So, is the force causing this work constant or not constant?
We do not have the force or the displacement.
Yeah, and neither of those equations have mass or velocity in them.
Right.
Actually, we are not going to use either of those equations. We are going to use the work energy theorem.
Oh yeah, the work energy theorem. Duh.
Why duh?
It's in the video title.
What video title?
The one right above your head.
I do not see it.
It's right there.
Where is it?
Is
it up here somewhere?
Yeah, so we need to remember that we can use what is typically called the work energy theorem. I prefer to call it the net work equals change in kinetic energy theorem.
I still do not see the video title. What video are we talking about anyway?
I am sorry, Billy. It will all make sense to you someday. All right. I prefer to call this equation the net work equals change in kinetic energy theorem rather than the nebulous work energy theorem because too many of my students forget it involves the net work and the change in kinetic energy. Bobby, please solve the problem.
Okay, well, we know net work equals change in kinetic energy or kinetic energy final minus kinetic energy initial or 1/2 mass times velocity final squared minus 1/2 mass times velocity initial squared. We can factor out 1/2 and mass and substitute in our values to get 1/2 times 5 times the quantity 2i plus 6j quantity squared minus the quantity 4i minus 3j quantity squared. How do we square a unit vector expression?
That is a fair question. Let's look at the example xi plus yj quantity squared to make sure we understand this. Realize to square something means to multiply it by itself. In the case of unit vectors, that means the dot product. So we can FOIL this.
First, outer, inner, last.
Right. And get xi dot xi plus xi dot yj plus yj dot xi plus yj dot yj. The dot product of xi and xi is just x squared because the two unit vector i's are in the same direction. The dot product of anything I and anything j is just zero because the directions of I and j are perpendicular to one another. And the dot product of yj and yj is just y squared, again, because unit vector j and j are in the same direction. So this works out to be that we just square each of the unit vector coefficients. However, it is important you realize why that is. All right, Billy, please finish the problem.
Absolutely. The net work then equals 1/2 times 5 times the quantity 2 squared plus 6 squared minus the quantity 4 squared minus 3 squared. That equals, 1/2 times 5 times the quantity 4 plus 36 or 40 minus the quantity 16 minus 9 or 7, and that equals 82.5 or 82 joules with 2 sig figs. I love the arcane rounding rule.
This is not correct.
That's what I got with my calculator.
Yeah, me too.
Well, it is still not correct.
I bet it is a negative.
Yeah, it's always a negative. Oh, it's the negative in the negative 3j in the initial velocity.
Right. That needs to be negative 3 squared because it's the dot product of negative 3j and negative 3j. And squaring negative 3 gives us positive 9. So it ends up being 40 minus 16 plus 9, or 25 instead of 40 minus 7. And we get 37.5, or 38 joules with 2 sig figs.
There we go. We always have to be careful with negatives. Lastly, please, do not forget the network equals change in kinetic energy theorem. It may come in very handy. And this equation is not on the AP Physics equation sheet, so please memorize it, because you will likely need it. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.